Here we go. This has relatively quick access to the room. The room that increases our storage capacity, and that'll really help me out right now. What are you doing, buddy? You feeling all right? Need some help? You need a doctor for your dead ass body? Oh, didn't mean to do that. My bad. Wow, I have that many toxins, huh? Let's really just combine some of these together to make it more worth it. There we go. I'm not necessarily going to use all of them individually, but I can pump up the power. And then when I do use one of them, it's more worth it. Doesn't really apply in the case of healing tonics. That's a level 1 killer cloud. They're actually surprisingly comparable in damage. One's like twice as effective as the other one, but first one is not negligible. I'll stack a few blazes. There we go. Take a material, just add every bone to it. What if there was like a billion bones in this thing? Doesn't that sound fun? There we go. Totally unreasonable use of bones. Not very effective, all things considered. Restore. I assume stacking you guys together also doesn't exactly lead to, well, in this case, it doesn't lead to any increased power because it doesn't go up a level. But it probably wouldn't lead to an applicable increase in PP restorage either, though. Is that? I think this is just a dead end over here, actually. I was thinking the place at the top left might connect to it, but I think it's just gonna go nowhere. Where are you at? There you are. Thank you. I mean, who wouldn't want the hell-spawned fish fillet from hell? I'm sure it's healthy. Somehow has gluten in it, though. A little confused about that. Our fish are 75% gluten. Don't ask. You're in the underworld. Hello. Oh, God. No. Ahaha! You fell into my trap. The trap where I accidentally bumped the circle button at the wrong moment, but then it profit. Ahaha! Alright, spirits. Oh, I probably have to kill the tentacle. You guys done? No! I was half joking, but that last tentacle was literally all that was left. There we go. Now our bag capacity has expanded. Fantastic. Oh, I can't carry because it's a seed. That's why. I understand. Let's magically just jam some seeds into a vial and see what happens. Yay! Extra fozons. Not that many fozons, though. There we go. Extra fozons! And I'll... Oh! Just threw a bone. Didn't mean to do that. And I'll follow that up with... Extra fozons! Now I got fozons for days! You're a fozon. And you get a fozon. And you get a fozon. And you get a fozon. And they all come in here. Yum. There we go. That's one way to deal with seeds. Could have saved them for battle. But honestly, it's usually not that hard to get fozon for casting during combat. But I can use those to level up. And that's not negligible. Not one bit. It's a lot of bones. Almost as if they belong here or something. Oh, missed one. Thank goodness for the map, because it's kind of hard to see in here. That definitely helps with identifying which things I have and haven't interacted with correctly yet. Not a ton left of this dungeon. I keep running into walls, because I think that going that way is going to be the right way to go. But around these parts, we apparently just go... We walk all the way to the far wall, but then hit up to go into the background. Which is a change of pace from the usual city-type layouts that... often involved just walking straight through the walls. There we go. Thank you. Ooh, even more. While also attacking the boss directly. Very handy. He doesn't seem not really happy about any of this, really. That's fine. He won't be alive for much longer. Or not. He won't be unalive for much longer. I don't know what to call him. It's freaking me out, man. Oh. That seems like an attack I don't want to be caught in. So let's do this and have a bunch of slowdown. Sweet. It's variably effective. Oh. Well, you gotta disappoint me. There's all these dramatic slowdowns happening. You've cut off my supply. A decent number of them actually connect on the way to back down. Gotta start back a little further back than I have been. Where are you going? We were just having fun, I thought. Oh well, thanks for the Fozons, I guess. Oh, Fozons, please. Faster, faster. Oh! Real damage happening. It's alright, buddy. Oogie boogie, you can just go down. Beetlejuice oogie boogie. Oh, no. Thank you. Boom! Let it happen. Let it happen. It's okay. This has to be helping with my chain-based damage that I get in this game. Unfortunately, if you reload, you pretty much are doomed to lose it. So you can only get it so high before the chain takes it all out. Clear. Nice, safe S rank. And we got ourselves a new key. So getting to exactly here is where I needed to go to actually beat the level. Got it. Oh, got a little... Oop, items. A few of them, actually. Alright, let's find our way to this little dead end. And not too much longer till we're out of the underworld, hopefully. Thank you. What you doing, little buddy? Just having a swell old time, hanging out, doing your thing. Oh, there we go. Seemed like there would have to be something around. Found it. Are we about to get ambushed? Oh, it's a secret skill. Got it. Well, thank you. I was just thinking about spending Fozons on upgrades anyway. What do you do? Skill link. That sounds like a passive. Increased damage dealt for every skill used in a chain up to 3 times. Wow, yes. I love chaining, I love to change, chain skills together. That's pretty perfect. It's like they know me. Already did that one. Let's pay a visit to the main damage source. Yeah, we can upgrade the actual weapon again. +8 attack. Got it. Not much else you can probably do with that money. Yeah, it's too much for that. Do have a third point, though. Let's see. What's my next goal might actually be to go down here. More knockback when you're full. Decrease damage while reloading. Increase reload speed. Yeah, those are all probably worth it. And they're relatively cheap. They feel within the grasp of what I can acquire while I'm playing the main game. Because it's only this chapter and the epilogue, and you never know how long the epilogue was going to be. Although in many cases, the epilogue is the longest chapter of the entire campaign. Which is not how epilogues tend to work. Maybe it's a translation thing. Maybe they treat epilogues more differently in Japan. Maybe they're not even... Maybe the Japanese version doesn't even call it an epilogue. Who knows? Howdy. Just want to put a few things away. So many bones. There we go. Somehow I convinced myself to... Somehow I was sitting here thinking, how is my inventory so full? Of course it's full because we're, in here of all places.
I will not hand over my treasure. Eh? Why didn't you say you had money? My greed is the very reason I'm down here, but I do not regret it.
Area map. Seems a little pointless, but I'll grab it anyway. Detox Charm, Ancient Crystal, Moon Pendant. More hit points, more POW recovery. Kinda wanna grab a few of those, honestly. Just wear three of them at once. Have a bunch of health and POW recovery, while also having a decent chunk of defense is part of the reason I want it, because my current equipment is really low on defense, and I think it's starting to feel it. Yeah, the other ones are relatively minor by comparison. Oh, shield ring. There we go. Got him. So I should have a decent chunk of health now and a decent chunk of defense, I believe. Defense 51. That feels like a decent start. While having, what, 45% increased health? Was my health full previously? Because that would... If that extra chunk of health is how much more health I have, that's pretty crazy, actually. Maury's Touring Restaurant. We'll solve any crime before bedtime. Oh, I can add one of my own supply. I think that one was 19 and this one was, what, 12? Yeah, so 31? Yeah, just throw an apple in there, we're good. Get it planted. Maybe we'll have an apple sorbet. She's so excited to see the crops come in. Yay! Please, there we go. Gotcha. Two new recipes, both involving shrimp. May not have a lot of those. Oh, there's one. I can do that one. Or I can do the Mongol confit. We'll just focus on this one for now. I have enough to make two. Nice. Bring it. Bring it to me. Now look at that.
Enjoy your meal.
Now don't that just seem downright delectable? And she eats it in three bites, because she's got super... Oh, two bites. Was that just two? Anyway, she has eating superpowers. I don't know if you guys knew about that. She tries to keep it on the down low.
Very well. Leave it to me.
I will. Fine. 34.
Will that be all?
Feeling especially high level compared to the actual requirement of the area. Map's looking pretty full except for the boss area and what's right in front of me. Alright, let's check it out. Hey! No escape. No escape. You're mine. Hope you're a fan, because you're mine now. Hey! Okay, it's getting a little crowded around here. Oh, jeez! Alright, time to shoot everywhere at once. The secret is just to cover the entire screen with attacks. Brought that butterfly back. I'm trying to have faith in it. But I don't know if it really does much damage in many cases. It occasionally attacks. A lot of enemies are not really within its attack range. Boom! Hello. They seem rather crowded around us at the moment. Boom! Rude. Gonna have to ask you to step off. Now bring me your fozons before I get angry. Right? Right? Hey there. Calm down. And clear. Nice. Ooh, a shrimp. That'll be fantastic for the cooking supplies. Maury's gonna be so happy with me. He won't even know. He doesn't know the bleeding I go through just for his restaurant, trying to get it off the ground. Will he ever be satisfied, truly? Or will he only ask for more blood? That's really what's going on here, is I'm massacring entire landscapes of people so that I can get enough meat and vegetables to, sate his appetite. You're the ultimate dragon to be chased and never caught. and whatnot and things and stuff. Alright, Mori, what can you do with shrimp? It's funny how the whole thing's even, the whole game's even dark and sad and everything's awful, and then you get to him and the music picks up and gets happy. It's like, yay, this is why it's all worth it. Why I do all the murder. That's 7,700. That's 7,300. Oh, this one's worth more. Because it's the expanded version of the other one is why. Wow, got a lot of that one fruit.
Very well. Leave it to me.
The shrimp is mine. And so is the level.
Will that be all?
Probably, yep. Looks like it. Unless I want to buy some more shrimp, which maybe. Maybe, you know? Let's pay a quick visit. I love the animation where he actually reaches over and picks it up each time. That makes the whole thing funnier. I'll grab one shrimp. Give me your underworld shrimp. I'm sure it's really healthy. After all, they have a really strong FDA in Deadland. Wait, I should have put away the shrimp. I guess it doesn't matter. I'm about to use it. I'm about to spend that shit. Hey, Mori. Guess what? Let me guess. Mori's Touring Restaurant. Yeah. We have oh, we ran out of one. Oh no. That one's recent. That one's decently valuable though. I can settle.
Very well. Leave it to me.
There you go. Seafood pasta. And we're very close to 36. Nice. Alright, get ourselves back to our checkpoint and we can revisit the fight location. Where's the note? Where is the nearest checkpoint? Whoa! There's one at the beginning. One at that rest stop. Oh, I'm standing on top of it. I was like, how is there no checkpoint on this entire chunk of the map? They are weirdly sparse. There's one here, one here, one here. And that's it? It's just, I guess there's a starting one, of course. This entire top half of the map, not even half, this entire top, like, two-thirds of the map has one checkpoint in it. Period. Bit of a surprise. Thank you. The moon key is yours to do with as you wish. And whatnot. Anyone gonna challenge me? Oop. No go free. I'll find you all. And of course, of all things, there's a checkpoint right there. In literally the next room.
Here too? Didn't you become queen after defeating Melvin's rebellion?
Brom, I came here to rescue you.
What in blazes? The queen came for me? I cannot thank you enough.
I need your help. Now come, follow me.
Insects are restless. You shall not escape, Brom. You will continue to serve me by crafting your wonderful jewelry. That is what your life is for.
I am Mercedes, Queen of the Fairies. Queen Odette, I wish to speak with you.
Who your people choose to rule is no concern of mine. This is where human souls are destined to rest. This place means nothing for you fairies who live like the mist. You thieves who steal my belongings. All I need is to crush the bugs who have crawled in here.
I guess talking to you is out of the question.
I love how there's just continually less and less actual lead up to somebody attacking the Queen of the Undead, the Queen of the Underworld. It's just kind of accepted, like, oh, I guess this is gonna happen now. You know, it's just everyone fights the Queen of the Underworld. It's just a normal thing that happens. That's a lot of consecutive attacks, wow. And then I soaked up more. Mwahaha. In fact, there's even more in the distance. Let's destroy some tentacles for exactly that purpose. Yummy, yummy. Yummy, yummy. There we go. Here we go. Thank you for continually providing me with more ammo. It's very cordial of you, honestly. Oh, fireballs. Fires that hurt. That hurts. Oh, look. Candleman's here. He just wants to watch. He likes to watch. Wow, I'm missing hard. Wasn't spacing myself away like this, the way I should have been. Oh. Fozons ahoy. Got him. Oh yeah. Doesn't feel so great, does it? Actually, it's not very effective. This is Oh. Invulnerable, huh? That's how we're gonna play it? Oh, yep, they're charging. Like some kind of nightmarish arachnoid tractor. What? When did you become nightmare house spawn tractor? I can't jump over it. Ah, fly. There we go. It's like I'm playing Limbo. How do you feel about... Ha 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 ha. That was a bummer. Where are you going? Why must you flee from me? I only want to show you love. Wow, I actually can't go through the leg, of all things. Not a whole lot of AI going all of a sudden. She's suddenly really the most avoidable enemy ever. Thank you. Oh, you're sucking them back up. I don't like that. Don't do that. Consumer of Fozons. Ow. Wow. Danger zone. Alright. Her last health bar is the nastiest one, apparently. Ow. Fire still homes back around the corner after you at that point, huh? Boom. Not a whole lot of you left. I think I'll just keep shooting, honestly. Here we go. Finish her. Thank you. Thank you.
How dare you shoot that sickening red jewel? What is happening? King Galen is upset. Why is he acting up now? Get more chains! Tie him down! Come, Arya. Don't waste your time on that one.
I don't know what just happened, but I think we're safe. Let's get out of here.
You want me to create another cipher? Are you asking me to forge another Belder Reaver? I'm sorry, even if it is the Queen's command, I cannot perform this task.
No, Braum. You can do this without selling a soul to the Halya.
Tis impossible. I cannot create a cipher as enormous as the Balor.
It doesn't need to be large. as long as it can compete with the Demon Lord's Baylor.
I cannot create a cipher as powerful and destructive as the Baylor, but a cipher that is able to break the Baylor itself. A different design. Interesting. Let's try it.
I like how our first campaign climactically ends with the concept of how that character will never let... Oh, what? Normal attacks do not consume power for a time. Cost 11 Fozons. Still not bad. Especially if it lasts a decent amount of time, which unfortunately doesn't say. I like how our original playthrough ends with the comment that, like, nobody ever escapes the underworld, and I am the ultimate queen, and blah blah blah, I'm so spooky scary. And then now everyone seems to escape the underworld, and by the time we get to this character, she's, like, it even ends with, like, oh, come on, don't waste your time on them. She's dismissive of us. It's like, what happened to nobody escapes? Seems pretty easy all of a sudden. Maybe not easy, but seems pretty possible all of a sudden. Through repetition.